in there.
Yeah.
warning. LSA?
Okay, here's David Newbert on the left-hand side. I've told the story about how he's got a roadkill drivetrain out of one of our old project cars in this thing. He's trying to run 11s every day. He did not have a functional nitrous solenoid earlier in the day, and he was able to borrow one from Dave Schroeder, arguably, well, and in fact, the best, most fastest, most goodest nitrous car on.
I like how you covered up most fastest.
Wasn't it fantastic? Most goodest. It was the best, most fastest, most goodest nitrous car on the property. Let's see if it rubs off on Newbern's Nova. And on the right-hand side, Wayne Wills in the 2010 Camaro.
Wills may be the least bestest Camaro. Who knows? Most goodest versus least bestest.
You're just jealous. Camaro's having some difficulty. I see brake lights. Hopefully he can get that thing over to the side.
Driveline problemos there as David Newbern, 11.53.2 at 117 miles an hour. Oh, huge smoke down there at the top end of the racetrack for Newbern. You see a giant instantaneous cloud emitting itself from the base of the engine. I was honest to God about to say, well, at least the connecting rods are still in it. And then that happened. So
because roadkill. And here comes the safety, not safety safari, but the track safety in order to make sure that he's okay. And I say, go out in a blaze of glory.
Right over to the side, pull Dave Newbern. Meanwhile, we have another racer that's marooned out there by the eighth mile. We're going to get him a tow or a push off the racetrack here momentarily.
See, what happened here is the roadkill curse struck Newbern and then rubbed off.
Yeah, much like
on
Bobby,
Wills in the right-hand lane.
Much like Bobby Brady with the cursed tiki doll.
Exactly.
That episode
like
of the Brady Bunch. That is what that engine is.
Well, I think maybe Newbern's engine went off sort of like Peter Brady's volcano. It might have looked a little bit like that.
Man, that cloud's still just hanging in the air down there on the right side of the race.
Ah, man, hang time. You know, if you're going to do it right.
I know, but I'm gonna pull you in.
Oh, yeah. Pump
you in. All right, you ready?
Get in line.
You stay there. All right, y'all ready?
Oh, that's the D. There we go.
Oh, you get the free T-shirt. Oh,
man. I shook the tires.
So you may be asking yourself, why would they be scrubbing down a junk motor that they paid $500 for just to go spray it with nitrous? Well, it's because we care. See, we're going to go to a drag strip, and at the drag strip, the last thing you want to do is drop 200,000 miles worth of grease and oil all over your, you know, the race truck. That's just not cool. And pretty much this is the only 150 horsepower motor that needs an engine diaper, which we don't have. So brake clean, brush, clean it before we put it in. Then you can make like 97 nitrous passes in a row.
Sounds good.
Or one big kaboom with no
food.
We got it somewhere.
I got pop dope.
You got pop dope?
Yep.
It's pipe thread. It's right there. Whatever you want to do. You got it? Is it handy?
Oh, yeah.
Hold on.
Yeah.
All right.
We doesn't have a light over here. So,
these guys run.
That's like.
You know, that's one of them things. You don't use it and have it and leave. You know, if you don't have it and need to use it, it won't ever.
The guy at Thunder Valley gave him that decal last night when we got done putting the motor in. He hung out the whole time and waited for us to fire that thing off.